program, somebody else's program, and then kind of
you don't have
go from there and get back to you.
You don't have time. You came to me with a problem. You're 36 years old. You don't have two nickels to rub together. You've been having this problem over and over again. This is your winning lottery ticket, sir. Do you want to put it in the shredder or do you want to cash it in? God bless you if you fire me. But would you do me just a small favor? Would you fire me right now? Because I don't have the time and I'd love to work with you and solve this problem. But I don't have the time to go back and forth and leave voicemails and stuff. You came to me with a problem. I offered you a solution. I can do financing if that's what you want. Can we move forward or is it over? You pick.
Man, I learned this from Dave. He told me this, Chris, but you need to go back, Chris, and listen to what Claude said and write that down and internalize that and make it your own, because like you're listening to that, but that, like, I'm going to go back and listen to that because I get that a lot. Like, oh, I need to research, but that right there is going to either, they're going to more than likely buy today or heck with them.
Yeah.
Time somewhere else.
Great. So you're like, oh, go ahead.
No, you go. Go ahead. Finish your thought.
So you're restating the problem. So basically they're telling in the beginning, you know, when your discovery questions, basically they're telling you all the things that are important to them. Like, you know, I want to break free from my 9-to-5. I want to spend more time with my kids. I want to, you know, I'd like to have more money in the bank so I can save for retirement. Right now, I don't have that. So basically I have that. Listen, you came to me and you said you want to spend more time with your kids. You know, you don't have time to spend with friends. You want to have more money for retirement, all that. You know, I can't work with everybody and I don't really want to do the back and forth. So can we move forward or is it over?
Yeah.
You pick.
You should call that the dragnet close, Claude, because it's like, just the facts, ma'am, just the facts.
That's really good. I'm going to use that this week.
You've got to, when you're speaking to people, you've got to basically find 3 to 6 needs and greeds, I call them. Motivational factors, emotional quotients, has a lot of different names. They didn't wake up one morning and say, gee, I'm going to call up Brent Bowers or Chris Logan and give them a shitload of money. They called you up because they have a problem. They're looking for a solution. You're probably not the first person they called, but how are you going to make yourself unique? This goes back to Brent's idea in the beginning there about ego. Are you the only one who fired them or rejected them politely with your assertiveness? Can you imagine what's going, wow, no one said that to me before. This guy doesn't need me. This person doesn't need me. They're busy enough. Am I missing out on the world, Dave? Hold on. Am I missing out on the one opportunity to change my world? How powerful is that emotionally, psychologically?
Huge.
It's huge. How much guts, back to the course, how much guts does it take for us to reject the prospect? This is a big, this might be uncomfortable for many of you, because when you have a nice conversation, you're on the honeymoon. Hey, you know, Ed, I really like you. Your information is great. I love your chihuahuas and everything. I'm going to think about this tonight. I'm sure I'll get back to you in a day or two, buddy. You're a good guy. You're the best. Out of all the people I've talked to about this real estate deal, you're the best realtor, the best investor, the best financer. I'm sure we're going to do business in the near distant future. How?
Yeah, that'd be great. And should I just send you an agreement for everything we discussed so far? We can get this taken care of today.
Yeah. Send me all the information. Send me the agreement. I love collecting contracts. That they won't say that, but that's what they mean. Right. I'm sure I'll talk to my wife tonight. I'm going to light a candle in church. All things being equal, I'm almost positive we'll move forward someday.
Excellent. Well, what do you say we just get on one knee now and we can pray and take care of this, and I can get this sent over to you. We can take care of this, and you guys can just take your wife out to dinner tonight.
Well, you know it. I have two more other gurus to call. I mean, you were the best by far and everything. Like, I don't like to rush into these things. I've made mistakes in the past.
Yeah, I understand. Well, listen, when you guys decide that you want to move forward, you've got my number.
Okay. See, you were nice. I want you to be No, sir, it's over. I want you to say, no, sir, it sounds like it's over.
Yeah, it sounds like it's over. Right.
I want you to literally fire the guy, kind, nice and gentle. And I want, what is he going to be thinking of all day long about Ed? Wow, yeah. No one's ever said that to me. This guy told me, and you can set a time frame. Ed, reverse engineer it, reverse role play. Ed, you know what? You have until 6:30 today to call me back. My offer is good till then. After then, it's off the table forever. And you have a chance to change your life, to move forward, to do all the things you want, to leave the job, to pay the bills, to go to Hawaii, to buy more chihuahuas, whatever you want. Okay, but after 6:30 today, it's over. What do you think is going to be in his head all day long?
Right. Yep.
Tell me how powerful that'll be.
That is, and I think you hit it right on the head. I was being too nice.
You're in the listen. We're all nice people. We're all nice and very attractive people in this room, if I may say so. Yeah. That was a stroke.
You remember the line from Roadhouse? I want you to be nice until it's time not to be nice.
Okay. Is that what you want? And I cut you off before, David, you had your hand up.
I was just going to say that most salesmen, like you always do the flip side, most salesmen are going to chase to stay on that call. You know, they're going to rebuttal. They're going to come back with another comeback to try to keep them, you know, the opposite way. They're going to practically beg for the business rather than take it off the table, and then you're making the prospect close themselves.
Yeah. Make the prospect close themselves. Make them think the belief that you are finally the straight person, the honest person in a crazy world. You're the one person who's going to get them to where they want to be. You're going to help them feel better. You're going to remove the pain. You're going to be accountable. You've got to make them feel, it's ego. Once again, you've got to make yourself unique in the eyes of the prospect. So when they get off the phone, they'll say, wow, that Chris Logan, he's different. Hey, Chris, I'm sorry. If you've been in my mind all day long, I thought about what you said. Let's just do this, man. I believe in you. I really, you know, what the stuff you said, man, it, I don't know if you know this, but it's been resonating in my head all day long.
Great. Well, I'm so glad you called. Let's get it going.
Okay. Give me a super stroke here. Cause
yeah, remember, you know, you made a really smart decision by giving me a call back. I mean, you know, a lot of people are not looking to make the lifestyle changes that you're looking to make at such an early age. So congratulations on that. And I'm really looking forward to helping you change your future.
There you go. Boom.
Would that have been a spot after you said what you said? Would that, instead of great, let's get going, would you have said, would you have normally said, what would you like to do next?
Well, if Chris calls me back, and I did that role play verbatim, that was verbatim. I have actually had phone calls like that where people said to me, you've been in my head all day. Because we did those guts moves, we fired them, or we gave them a time frame, a fail-safe time frame here, you know. And they called me back and said, Claude, I haven't thought of nothing else all day long. I don't want to lose out on this opportunity. Because you took it away from them, you used scarcity. You said, this is what I do. This is the way. I'm not going to chase you. You used social proof. Hey, I'm busy. I've got a lot of clients. Then you set that, and then you used authority, and you said, the offer goes off the table at 6:30. This is very strong selling, assertive selling. Okay. But I think it differentiates you. So you get a phone call like I just did with Chris. I have actually had those phone calls. Brent, have you ever had, or Chris or anybody else, have you ever had a phone call where somebody said, you know, I've been thinking about this all day long. Let's just do this. You know, my wife's going to kill me. My dogs don't like me, whatever.
Oh, yeah. You got to be willing to lose the deal to keep the authority position.
What happens?
This is an area that I got to improve, because something I've been doing in old traditional sales have taught me that if someone's not ready right now, then, you know, you say, okay, won't be a good time for me to follow up with you. And they're like, oh, I can't get started now because I got work. And, you know, I got all this stuff going on this week. So I'll be getting going. You
can follow contact them five times.
Yeah. That's how I've always gone about it. And that's how I've always been taught. So this is a big shift for me doing it this way.
It's a tremendous shift. It's a hard shift for a lot of people. Not everybody loves your Uncle Claude in this method. Okay. Total honesty. I know it works for me and I'm nobody special. And I think people are in this crazy world where everybody's so angry and emotional and confused. I think they're looking for leadership, sensible, common sense leadership. You guys can disagree with anything I say. This is just subjective here. And I know you guys are going to give good value. I know you're going to answer emails, return phone calls. I know you're going to give solutions to people. Why shouldn't we be proud of that?